Alright, welcome back to the second hour of the show, and of course, time check. It is 8 minutes past the hour of 10 a.m. We're getting into our love situation this morning, and we do have a particular lady writing to us and saying that, "Hello, Aben. I met a guy while I was 17 years walking mangoes on street, on the street. This was because I lost my mom while I was 15 years, and my stepmom forced my dad to throw me out. This guy was also a vendor on the streets of Kampala. He hustled day and night to get money, and he saw me through school. Fast forward, now I'm done with the university, and all thanks to him. He wants to marry me, but honestly, I do not love him. I'm thankful for all his help this entire time, but I really cannot marry him. Don't judge me, please, but truth is that I look at him as a father figure in my life. Now, how do I tell him that I can't marry him without breaking his heart? Should I just accept the marriage proposal, or I should move on and hustle on my own? My friends insist that I should stay, and probably with time, I would grow in love with him. Aben, today, what do you advise here?" Well, it's very sad that you actually lost your mother when you were 15. That's first things first. And looking at the fact that you've been hustling from 17 years of age on the streets of Kampala until you met this vendor, I must say, you know, kudos to you. You knew what you wanted, and now you have achieved it. But now, coming back to the real deal here, is how do you tell this man you cannot marry him? Because looking at someone as a father figure, and then the other person coming to you and they tell you that they want to marry you, is also another disturbing thing. So, I don't know, Tina, you want to go first on this one?
Aye, man. You know what? Y'all guys need to let our emotions circle down a little bit. Like, every time you guys write us a letter, I'm like, okay, what we have in this time? I've run out of how many times to say run. I can't run anymore. I'm not even letting y'all run. But
they should just disappear.
Should just vanish. Whoa. Okay. First of all, we do have to commend her. Age of 17, making your way out on the streets of Kampala. You meet someone who is kind enough. He means probably he saw something in you that you even probably didn't think you had. Now, years down the road, there's a saying in Lusoga, you know, that bird that likes to eat bananas, right? Little kakuchi, you're the Musoga.
Ah, you're the one who has brought it.
Leave me alone. Anyway, I'm looking at it. It's a very confusing predicament that she's in. This is something that's confusing. Bound to hurt both of them, regardless of if she says yes or if she says no. At some point, someone is going to get hurt. And there's no way, people that you can tell yourself, so how do I walk away without hurting someone? It's a given. When you walk away, you're hurting someone. That's just it. Someone is bound to get hurt. If you see him as a father figure, I understand how that could sexually be off. So off. I'm only going to take it as a sexual.
Yeah, I mean, father figure.
And then again, I don't think that's her problem, actually. I don't think she sees him as a father figure.
No, she does. Nah. She just said it. Her two problems are she sees him as a father figure, and then she does not love this man.
Thank you. Which clearly states, Obuzibubualina is his status.
Because
she feels now she's gotten an education, she's bound to be getting things. She wants to also be an ordinary girl. You have to understand, it's just human nature. If you start from the ground up and you're building towards something, you're just going to want to keep elevating. You can't keep holding yourself in one kasako. So whether she stays or goes, I don't know. I'm not giving advice on that. That's too complex for me.
Willis, the young lady right here making it out of the university with the support of a street vendor who turns out to be in love with her.
Again, let me grab the bull by the horns.
May
the thought of this guy haunt you. May you think about this guy every time you put your head down on the pillow to sleep.
Clearly she is.
May you dream about this guy. In fact, may you also daydream about him.
But why? Ngomagalizabubi.
May wherever you turn, you see his image. May you smell his perfume in every man you
see. I don't think he wears a perfume.
But you see, this is like saying the devil came and gave me an apple.
Oh, you're going to
I love the apple, but I don't like the devil. What sort of crap is that?
I love
that. You like what they're given.
Naira is a situation. Naira is a bakazi. Kuwera dala. Biari woku Eva. She liked the apple, but didn't like the devil. But she took the apple nonetheless. Why are you taking some guy's money for school fees if you don't love him? He's not your brother. He's not your father. He's not your cousin. He's not your friend.
Oh no.
Yatanika ina kumi nyamsambi.
Yamsanga ku street.
guy.
Ache guy. Uh-huh. Did
he has never said anything
his
like I like you.
Clear. Exactly. But did he
guy
say
that? Guy atogede. Ngomwala maze kusoma.
Ante kankubuze.
That guy na mgamba. Ngiri jo maze.
Kankubuze. Did this guy at one point say that he works for an NGO?
No, he didn't. I mean, clearly he didn't.
Did he say he was a pastor that works for a church?
No.
Probably not.
So, what did you want?
Can you help someone?
No, Derek,
without expecting anything in time?
You're not expecting anything. Yeah. I'm not, you know,
I've never helped anyone.
I do it all the time.
Uh-huh. So, what do you expect in return?
These are emotions. And let her not try to lie to us that the guy just woke up one day and wanted to marry him since you're 17. Mm. Yeah. Of course, he must have been dropping lines. He must have been showing interest.
While she was 17, that was the list of her issues at the moment. And let's face it.
These days, people breaking their boat at 13. You're talking about 17.
But you see, breaking their boat in the marriage.
Leave the boat. Leave the boat. First of all, she was 17.
Yeah.
And I know for a fact, even he could see she is that young. Mm-hmm. So in terms of her, of him dropping, you know, like tell-alls, like red flag, I don't think he did it on the, like, on the jump, from the jump. I think he started to throw them when he saw she's of age.
Yes.
Now.
Like at the university?
Yes. Mm. Mm. Now, why would you blame her?
She has finished university. She's probably 24, 25.
Exactly. Mm. Why would you blame
her? So for 4 years, you couldn't tell this girl was vibing you.
I've known people.
She was focused on her books because she had her miserable history.
And she wanted to get away from life.
But getting money from a source, from a guy.
No,
this is not money that she was getting at a gun point.
Banaye, batugamba nganga tuli bato. Ngabobewa kango tambula okuviwa kogenda kusomero. Our parents used to tell us, do not accept sweets from strangers.
Those were your parents. Let me tell you something.
You understand?
No, let me tell you something, Willis. Chino njangara chigamba abasajja abali eyo. Mulekera okwe kubyanga emizimu. You come and give us your money. Ngate tuziba sabiye. Nemuzire tanga, you believe that is the only thing you can stand on. Netu ziria, atena mtaniko kabanga with this. We are not going to feel sorry for you and your bank account. If you come to me, and money is what you're fronting.
What we want.
Start it.
When Zelenga went, okay, you're 17. Zengenda kula vidira. Na ime bangenda kula vidira. Nja kumanyati after the university.
You see, that
ogena kwa mkazi wangu. That thing would save a lot of men.
There are many things that she's not. She probably would have wrote something longer. But listen,
yeah, she left a lot.
This guy, during this time, must have told her. Mm. You know, they must have been in a relationship.
I doubt.
I'm telling you, if someone pays for you first year, okay, from 17, then you go to first year, then they drop lines, and then you push them away. Honestly, which man can be giving you money, even though you're giving them negatives? What conversations do you have when you meet him for school fees? What conversations do you have when he gives you lunch and supper? When he comes to your hostel, the one he pays, what conversations do you have?
Let me tell you, I know a chick who has had this guy on a leash, and he has never even touched none, but she has had this guy on a leash for 10 years.
They have the conversation.
Yeah, I like you. I like you too. But I don't know. I'm not there. He's like, it's okay. Men or women out there, when you step out of your comfort zone to help another individual, state your intention. Come correct with your intention. And this one goes to both parties. The one giving and the one receiving. Because other than that, tugenda kubera mukwesikana ku. If someone comes up to you, well, if you walk up to me and your conversation, you feel the only way it can carry weight is with money. I will eat that money.
We're going for a very short break, but when we do get back, studio lines are going to be open. The number to call is right there on your screen, 0414-337-872. You'll give us a phone call and let us know what should this lady do regarding her love situation.